Welcome to the Real Wrestling League. This is your host, Rob Williams, the fine bureaucrat who knows pretty much everything.
Whoa! And I'm the co-host, Will Bobians.
Yes, tonight is the most prized night of the night. This is the RWL Mystery Night.
Yes, this is not the official RWL, which should probably start around next decade or so.
I really hope it starts when... But never mind that, we have a new adventure coming up. We have Rob Williams and all the other friends here.
Yes, who are those new friends that you are talking about?
You will see, my dear friend. You will see. Alright. For our first, all the matches that are booked here are complete mystery. We will be commentating as they happen. Our first match is a tag team competition. This is Kayfabe on number 3 and Dark Fortune. This is going to be an interesting event.
Where are the other Kayfabians?
I don't know. Clarence Mason is the referee. Simon Slitzer and Dash River. This means this is a creativity contest. I wonder why these two are feuding right now.
I have no idea either. Oh, Simon Slitzer is about to pose or something.
Yes, he's going one-on-one against Kayfabe and is putting him into the test of a lifetime. I need a minute. That is very odd. Kayfabe on number 3 is beating up Simon Slitzer while Clarence Mason is just running everywhere. Two. They are already brawling on the outside. A proud RWL tradition.
What is the difference between Forten and Dark Forten?
I don't know. Oh, and a nice little DDT or something from Kayfabe on number 3. Simon Slitzer is putting him on a headlock or something.
I said you have so good at the bouts.
They are trash-talking each other. Why was this match sanctioned? We have to, by the ringside, we have Root, the leader of creativity, talking about this. So, Root, how are you doing? Very well, thanks for asking. What is the meaning of this match that is going to happen right now? I have no idea. I hate wrestling and I hate everything about it. Why did you invite us here?
Well, we are stuck on some sort of a purgatory here. But I don't think that matters very much.
And Kayfabe attacks to Dark Forten. Dark Forten kicks him into right into there. Simon Slitzer is out of the ring. Oh my goodness. That'll fix him for not listening to my comments about this newsy web series.
What is the web series that he is working on?
It's called The Red Anus. It's apparently one of those funny etsy cartoons that are existing in the internet.
Etsy cartoons? Aren't they animating cartoons with pencil sharpness now?
No. It's a cartoon is that there's a lot of dark humor and something. The Red Anus is just like that, but it's like it has gross out stuff, but it's also very progressive and such PC and all. Because Simon Slitzer is also a fashion designer and he works as the creative via intercom announcer.
Oh, and Dark, they are back into the ring where Dark Fortune is fighting.
He is trying to make Simon Slitzer is completely blooded. Well, it's not his fault.
Why are these two men teaming up?
I have no idea.
Whoa! Look at that, Kayfabe on 3 is back into the ring. I wonder when Das Favor gets some action.
Sir Clarence Mason is doing great job as a referee here. Simon Slitzer completely bloodied up. I don't really care what happens to him. Why are they standing around? They should be fighting.
Finally, Das Favor gets some action.
He is a good kid. He knows. He agrees with everything that I say.
Well, that's unfortunate. Simon Schlitzer still refuses to leave the ring.
It's not his thing to be egomaniac. Oh, here comes Dark Fulton.
Whoa! Das Weaver just missed.
You complete buffoon. This is why you aren't worth anything.
You are pretty mean, Rod.
I am not mean. I am critical of art. Art should be blood and suffering and everything else. This will be part of... Probably Das Weaver wants to make this part of his series, In the Jump of Man.
What is In the Jump of Man?
It was made by somebody. It's gay. We're talking about the brutalities of modern society through skating videos.
His fans are fickle.
What does he mean by that? Oh my goodness!
No! He got disqualified for using his signature weapon, the plank!
Why is this match for safety?
Looks like this is going to be a very odd match. But the crowd goes wild over it. They love it when people use violence in a match that shouldn't use violence.
No disqualification should be a thing that should be... I would watch wrestling more if it had more blood to it. Look at Simon Schlitzer. Oh no, is he coming to shit-talk me? Thank God. No, he is coming to shit-talk me.
Who was the KKBN leader revealed to be?
Don't you know the...
TPOS law. It was... old BH was KKBN leader all along, and we never animated it.
Whoa, that was kind of weird.
Maybe one day we will be a catching up episode on that. But right now, we have this match to focus on. Simon Schlitzer and Das Weaver are teaming up against Dark Fulton, who is their opponent, after KKBN 3 got disqualified for using his signature weapon, the blank.
Whoa, is Rob Williams or Rat talking right now?
Well, I am talking, supposed to be talking that Rat is just hiding in the sidelines. Yes, I am. Das Weaver is... Oh, he made the Dark Fulton bleed hard. But here comes Simon Schlitzer, whose face looks like a 3 a.m. night with his girlfriend.
That's pretty mean. Simon Schlitzer is doing his best in this match, you know. Das Weaver is trying to choke him to death. But Dark Fulton encountered it.
Oh my goodness, that is just mean. Simon Schlitzer is about to get his ass kicked, but here comes the Das Weaver tools from the outside. Dark Fulton could be about to get destroyed. Simon Schlitzer still is pretty confused. This probably might turn out to be a victory for Dark Fulton. If he successfully manages to pin him without Das Weaver getting any say in the matter. But here comes Das Weaver, they both are low on energy. Oh, Dark Fulton almost picked up the signature weapon of the plank.
Whoa, look at that, a nice suplex.
I don't think that's a suplex. I think that's just a bretto or whatever it's called. I'm not very good at wrestling him.
You both are geeks, you know that, right?
Whoa, Simon Schlitzer.
Simon Schlitzer is like a good coffee. You never know when you are going to get him, but the days when there is a good coffee, he is never around.
I don't understand the meaning of that.
Oh, rope break! Dark Fulton almost got it, but Clarence Mason is not having it. He is the bringer of justice in this ring. Damn right.
Whoa, and it's about to rub in. 1, 2, oh no, Das Weaver ruined it all. The humanity, is this going to be a... Oh my goodness, he is brutal, about to give him some special moves. I know that from that floating text that isn't supposed to be here. But where is he going? Is he a coward?
Why did he use his finish on the wrong guy? What did none of this make? None of the things in this match make sense.
Clarence Mason is trying to see if he can... Can he submit? Make Simon Slitch submit? Oh my goodness, that looked like it hurt. Willis, Dark Fortante, he tries to make him submit again.
But it failed. This should prove to be, I hope Dark Fortan does not screw up his chances of destroying Simon Slitcher. 1, 2, no, not even throwing him to a burning plank could destroy Simon Slitcher. He will never give up. That's right, these great winners have been through everything. They will not be easily faced by that weird bearded guy. Yes, Waver.
Not a nitro plate.
How does Gas Waver know? He was quickly trained, just like everyone else in this company, into this stupid role.
Yes, that is indeed right. Our good teacher, Coachy, helped to train all these wrestlers, all these random people into wrestlers. Is this happening? Oh no, Gas Waver just forced it.
That is not funny, Rob Williams. Sorry, you're literally 12-year-old. Not my fault, he admitted it. So this is great, as Weaver is an embarrassment to the entire company.
This is why there is a reason why Dash Weaver is a piece of shit.
I will expose the LOL.
What did you say, Rod?
Nothing. Okay, Dark Fortune is getting his... But Simon Slitcher, I have no idea what is happening right now. Are these guys supposed to be...
Yes, this is going to be an RWL tradition. This is going to be going into the countout.
No, wait!
Oh, just at the last minute, Dark Fortune scored the victory.
That is some amazing job that he's just did. Simon, yes, this is none of this.
Yes, that was exciting match. Thank you, Rod, for joining this battle and showing us how great life can be. What is our next match?
It's another, this time for the tag team championship, it's Zozad and Guy!
Yes. Hey, I love these guys, they are my favorite wrestlers. Oh no, Mr. E! And Silent Stranger, what a dangerous team.
I have never seen these two team up. This is such a random team.
Mr. E is feared opponent throughout the history. He is a mysterious character known for his strange mask and strange abilities. Some people say he is the son of Satan himself.
Well, I don't believe it. It sounds too stupid to be real.
Do not worry. I'm pretty sure that one day Guy and Silent Stranger... Sergeant Church is already fleeing and they already retained. Oh my goodness.
Well, that was a very easy and effortless match.
I wonder what's wrong with him.
Silent Stranger's profile has suffered considerably after being defeated so easily in that match. Whoa.
Well, that was not very... Both of these guys have gotten very... That was extremely easy to do. Why did Silent Stranger give up so easily?
I have no idea.
What is going to be our next context of amazingness?
It's going to be a one-on-one match this time. Oh, it's Scoopy Bacalan. I would gladly have a piece of her on my side.
Please don't be a pervert. Oh, Dave Prostito, this is going to be hard. Dave Prostito is going to destroy that poor girl. By my side, I have Poopy Packalin's fellow friend, Newt. Newt, how are you doing?
Well, I am doing pretty great on my end. What is going on here?
Well, Poopy Packalin is going up against Dave Prostito. What do you think? Why are these two fighting?
Me and the Hyphis and the NPS, that stands for Normal People Society, have had some disagreements lately. That is why I sent Poopy Packalin to him.
To fight that mysterious Dave Prostito guy. Well, he isn't very mysterious. I hate him. He's such a big loser, unlike me. I am the greatest person that has ever existed. Yes, and the crowd are very into this battle. They think that, I believe that Dave Prostito might be, in fact, a very good wrestler in the ring. Although he is not a very good person, he is an evil man.
Yes, but who cares? This is going to be exciting.
Yes, I know that for that Poopy Packalin can easily be that Dave Prostito, that big loser that everybody hates. Well, you are right about the fact that I don't think he is a big loser. This guy is dangerous. Oh, he had a sword when he came into the ring. I don't care less. Dave Prostito is injured. Poor guy. Oh, I almost feel bad for him. Not.
And this already is a great match. I can sense it. Poopy Packalin brought him down. The blood is spilling.
Can Poopy Packalin destroy Dave Prostito? Or is Dave Prostito claiming another victim to his evil army of Hyphis?
I hate you!
Oh no, that Dave Prostito is not giving a good example to the fans in the audience. He is an evil man. Yes, Poopy Packalin is a friend of mine. I like her because she always does what I say. Well, that sounds kind of eerie. But still, let's keep it on Rob Williams' statement.
Hey, and my name is Will Poppy, and you are Rob Williams. Are you having dementia or something?
I'm sorry about that. Oh. Oh my goodness, that is... That was one of the most intense pile drivers that I have ever seen. Poopy is out of the ring. They are going in and out, in and out, in and out, like some evil ritual. Dave Prostito is claiming his victim.
Well, I have no idea what is going on. I think Poopy Packalin might be a good guy after all.
Of course he's a good guy. She destroys all the legendaries. Excuse me, what?
Yes, haven't you heard of degenerates? They are disgusting, and we, the NPS, make sure that normal people will live in this normal society.
Okay, whatever you say. I don't understand why you and Hyphis hate each other so much, though. What is exactly... Renzi Backtrackins, what is he doing here?
I have no idea. Is he trying to calm down this match or something?
He is the owner of RWL. What is he going to do? Oh my goodness. What is... The referee is getting on his... Oh, which one will claim who? This is so exciting. I can't control myself. Well, I can, and I know that the Poopy Packalin will always win. Because Dave Prostito hasn't got anything on her. Oh, another beautiful chokeslam. One.
Why is Renzi Backtracking counting so slowly? He is very old. You will think that he wouldn't not be very excited about this. I don't even know why is he here. Is he making sure that hives do not interfere? Oh, that rhymed. Maybe I will finally get a TPUS rap battle parody going.
Please don't, will you? Even last time you tried that, you embarrassed all of us. And we had to convince these guys to be hired again.
Maybe one day we can put that on the internet.
Never! Alright, Poopy Beckerlein. She's taking offense. But what is exactly is she doing? Which one is going to win? Is this going to be a tie or is this going to be... Dave Forsythe almost... I know that Dave Forsythe might be on the stronger feet here. I know that Poopy Beckerlein will eventually get the upper hand over her. The crowd is getting tired of this match, despite the exciting action and something. Who is taking the one? Why can't they do this in this exciting changing of submissions in the ring?
I have no idea. They are probably Dave Prostitus going to the outside.
That poor kid. I feel so bad for him. Oh, I don't. He's an evil man.
How many times are you going to say that, Missy?
I guess it is one of my children.
Poopy Beckerlein will be get Dave Prostito to tap out. Oh no, here comes Iron Hand.
Iron Hand will make hands made out of that guy. Dave! Oh! That was a mean suplex. Who is going to take the victory here?
Poopy Beckerlein is just taunting. Oh my goodness.
One.
Two. No, no. 1 minute remaining. Will this be another quick victory? Or will this be a deadly facial of death? They have so little time, yet so little power. Will Poopy Beckerlein choke? Or will Dave Prostito choke? No, neither will choke. 30 minutes.
These fans are awesome.
Make that first minute count.
Poopy Beckerlein throws him right back where he belongs. Dave Prostito, what a joke that man is. They can't beat each other anymore. Oh, he won. Nobody won. He almost got it. But still, this was the greatest match in the history of RWL. Something tells me that.
We are back on the RWL Mystery Night. There's bound to be something interesting happening.
Well, let's see what we can dig up. Oh no, an 8-man tag team match. Just by so, Vexlery, OVH, Hyphis and Crabball and B.O.B. team up.
Oh, Clarence Manson is bringing everybody, anybody, Dr. Cox and Admin P. Well, it makes sense that Admin P and OVH are on the losing side, but what about everybody else?
Yeah, I thought Just by sir hated OVH.
Well, for what we could know, this could be something interesting. I know anybody has... I have no idea why anybody is part of the faction and Dr. Cox. Maybe Dr. Cox wants to link into the psyche of OVH. Maybe it finds it mysterious.
Could be. As far as I know, I don't know. This is certainly a very strange thing. Clarence Mason was the referee for the first contest. And now he's getting into the ring.
Yes.
And almost getting caught up in, but Vexler makes his way into the... Now old BH is part of the legal crew.
Yes, illegal. I get it. Because Clarence Mason is a lawyer.
Who will be the one to take the victory home?
have no idea this is part of old PH's and admin P's never-ending feud. It is certainly interesting when different factions actually team up.
He's stuck in anybody room.
Yes, anybody can enter the ring. Did you understand that? That's a joke, son.
Why didn't get it? Old PH and anybody are fighting on the inside.
Yes, anybody is kind of a weird guy. He technically, while he's part of GMHC, he is also pretty much. He has his own loyalty levels. I suppose Admin P paid him very well.
You're too stiff!
Did old PH say something about anybody?
Well, I didn't hear it. Wait a minute! Chivalry over!
What does he want to do? Is he... Or does he want to take fortune shares? I don't
know. I do have no idea. Maybe he's got something with anybody.
Maybe anybody insulted him somehow. This is odd. It's odd how these people managed it. Clarence is back into the ring. And now only the footer system. No one knew has allowed to be. Whoa. Some serious moves that will leave a mark. Clarence Mason is going to kick, punch some people, and Omni D Putters goes up. Clarence Mason, oh, what a...
Yes, Clarence Mason can kick ass. I wonder where is Inferno.
I have no idea. Omni D is giving him the best shot he can give. Clarence Mason asks, what is that?
Oh, here comes Joe Spicer. There's anybody. Anybody is back into there. He's taking on all.
Somebody really hates Dr. Cox. Who, and speaking of him, he's now legal.
Wexler is done. Everybody's getting their turn. Finally. This is going to be an exciting match full of different people taking on each other and admin piece. That means everybody in the match.
Two friends having to take on each other. Surely that's good. But now, never mind that, because only the Putters, I'm sure Admin P, considering Admin P's plans, she might really hate it. Hate Omni the Putters and other hypes.
Yes, old PH knew what to do just.
Whoa, that was a very nice. I suppose, powerbomb or something.
Only the Putters is back. They are using rapid switcheroos so that anybody cannot lay out consistent damage.
That is a very brutal strategy. I at least hope this match produces a winner. That's not a good, but it produces a winner. I hope this one does.
Oh, right into the box. We are taking out in the outside ring.
Someone's about to go. Old PH is giving him the finger.
Oh! Right through the stairs, and Jibberry Up has got something. They are both fighting for some reason.
Maybe Jibberry Up thinks Admin P giving bad names to the trans people.
Well, that's too political, and I really don't want to get into that. But Joe Spicer.
Admin, two enemies have taken on each other. Now there's some real heat. And he's out of the ring again.
He's very slow.
He can't help it. That does not look good. She may have gotten seriously injured there. What is up with this rivalry?
Whoa! Omni-Reputance is... Are they actually getting back into the ring, or are they continuing the fight?
Well, it's RWL tradition, fight on the sidelines until the time runs out. It's kind of stupid, but what can you do?
Oh no! Here comes Tiberi Ober with the baseball bat. Omni Ring is getting... it's turning into a gangbang again.
Well... what can you do?
Oh my goodness, Tiberi Ober is serious. Can he actually get inside the ring?
No. No, I think not. He's already back down in the ring and he's already starting to... Everyone's going out and getting ready to... This is good.
Oh, Tiberi Ober. He's handing the pasties again. Everyone's fighting. This is all exciting. Why is Josh Pizer beating off his own friend?
Maybe he wants this match to end fast.
Don't we all? Dr. Cox looks pretty injured.
Whose side are you on, little impudence? Since you don't want to have me on your side, please.
What happened?
I think there was drama happening right there.
Everyone's beating everybody. This is not good.
This is not good. This is a such a chaotic match. This must go. Somebody got injured.
What is going on anymore?
They are finally returning to the ring. Never mind.
What is wrong with these people? Why can't they stay in the ring?
Yes, that is very unfortunate, but only debutants. He is known for his aggressive moveset ability and Tiberi Ober constantly. Why can't Fulton do anything about it?
They are finally getting back into the ring.
Oh my goodness, that was a... He was suddenly turned on him and punched him in the face. That is exciting.
And Wimpy finally took someone who could actually take on him. Here goes anybody with this. What is... what... why is Fulton assaulting... He is not doing the job of a referee very well.
I don't know who... everyone's beating up everybody again.
I have no idea what is happening. Finally, we get some sense and order. Oh no, but omnipotence. He's countering him. It's amazing. Omnipotence is the Okada of RWL. Don't be silly. I really hope they try to get a good victory here.
Here comes Tiberi Ober.
Oh no, Dave, but the crowd hates it. Only the Putin is a total bully.
Yes, even anybody hates him. Chart, imagine, he's trying to... But he is too focused on Dr. Cole.
Well, Fulton has bad relationships. Bean!
Oh.
Neither this match does not produce a winner yet again. Maybe Wexler has a chance. Or Dr. Cole. Whichever we chose. They switch into the summer with full energy, but if that will be again. Oh my goodness, that was brutal. But at least we can go home happy knowing that this match exists. But I wish this would have produced a winner of some kind.
What? who can really stop it. He's strongest of them. He's the least used of the team.
Yes, he indeed is. I don't know, should I be worried?
No! He flew out of the stage like a banana. I can't believe it. Nobody is one.
Just by, sir. I'm here to challenge him to a match in the 4th week of July. If you got any guts, you are going to make me on a real match so we can see who's best.
What is going on? It seems Tivory opponents challenge Joe Spicer for a match.
That should be interesting.
Clannon, that was an interesting match, but it did not solve anything.
I agree, but at least the team battles were good. Office Iron Man match. Whoa, Bangkok.
He is accompanied by Michael Biggie and he has left Ivy's.
Who is his opponent? Mr. E, who failed earlier in the day to capture tag team titles. I suppose this is his second chance to get a victory.
Yes, but why are they taking lead on each other in an Iron Man match? That is it. A statistical impossibility.
Bangkok begins with a...
But Mr. E strikes back. They are taking on a massive room full of officers. How thankfully the crowd is not too much into this, but they certainly are for violence.
Maybe we hopefully see some... Whoa! Mr. E hold on stuck. With a serious blow to the back.
Yes, there may be some personal reasons. Ooh. Mr. E already has a fall of fuse puts in.
These officials will be able to produce an amazing match.
Oh, and that is a flaming chair. Maybe that would provide some serious brutality.
Yes, but Bangkok is trying to focus. Oh, Mr. E struck again. He's trying to get a pin, but why isn't the referee coming?
There he is. One, two.
Mr. E has got his second fall.
Meanwhile, Bangkok is pretty much lazy. He wants to go home.
I don't see how he wants to go home. Mr. E is so amazing. He could probably jump out of the open wheel.
Yes, but I know for a fact that he has to win and victory this already. After all, this is the son of Satan.
1, 2, 3.
Whoa, he's got a third fall already.
I don't know why Bangkok and Mystery are taking on each other. What is the reason this match existed?
Maybe they have disagreements. Bangkok is said to be a woman priced divinity. Somewhere where Bangkok is, I think, Thailand. And Mr. E is the mysterious individual. He supposedly was violently frozen in the 90s and he scored his fourth fall.
I'm not taking anymore.
But you're still forming a Bangkok since you don't want me here on leave.
Whoa, did we just see Bangkok and Mike Herbinkian break up?
That would be Mike Herbinkian is finally on his own. That should be very interesting.
Bangkok is doing his best to fight against the Mister, but how can he score 4 victories in a short matter of time? Mr. E is doing his best. Whoa! Jumped off the top rope.
This is going to be a very creepy match. I don't think I've ever seen anything like this. Mr. E's brutality is hard to control.
He tries another pin attempt. Bangkok's time.
Mr. E is uncontrollable.
Is Mr. E able to beat the poor guy?
I have no idea. Cassie, she's here to give some excitement to this match. I wonder who she has beef against.
We'll find out. Cassie hates Bangkok.
Well, Bangkok is a mysterious charmer. Maybe do you think they have or Bangkok has faced Cassie somewhere down the line?
One, two. Whoa, that didn't help at all.
Well, I suppose Mr. E will only find out later in life what is going to happen to him.
Bangkok flew all the way to the back of the crowd.
That was a very strong style move, but he is now sitting on a chair and now he's going back.
I wonder what their blood veil is.
Mr. E has got his fifth hole already. This is amazing. Mr. E is going to completely bury Bangkok.
Yes, maybe he's so angry that he lost the tag team challenge that he is now trying way better.
Why did he want to destroy Mr. E? Has got his sixth hole. Mr. E is about to score his seventh hole. He's just that man is already dead.
Yes, maybe somebody should interfere. And what is Cassie doing?
I have no idea. Hey Cassie, come over here. Can you explain why do you hate Bangkok?
Because he's a lazy ass motherfucker. I hate him. He sucks. He lies to me all the time.
Why? Cassie, come back. You don't need to beat him, Mr. E has already got him in his pool.
Well, that thing will be a mystery too.
Cassie, come here. Explain yourself.
But Cassie wants to take a piece of Bangkok on her own.
Bangkok doesn't care about Mr. E anymore. He just wants to kill Cassie. Whoa, that was a lot of blood. This is certainly not beating.
I agree. Whoa, peanut M. 1, 2, 3. Mr. E, like the wind, he has scored his eighth fall.
Yes, I just hope. I have no idea why Bangkok has so many enemies. I have barely seen him. He was the former KKB number 6, and a month later he became independent, and now he has no friends anymore.
Nine times. Will he break 10? Will he become the perfect mystery?
I don't know. Fortan is already tired of Cassie's bullshit and she wants him to get out. 1 minute remaining.
Mr. E is number 10. Mr. V will also be number... almost. It's fine to end up there, to be honest. Cassie hates Bangkok so much he wants to doesn't want to escape.
Well, Cassie, can you explain why do you hate Bangkok so much?
Well, I won't explain. I hate his guts. He's such an unruly idiot.
Well, why do you constantly want to beat him up?
Hold on, let me go beat him up again.
No, Mr. E is the winner. He completely destroyed Bangkok.
No, he will strike.
He is waiting to get the tag team titles.
What is our next match going to be? It's a one-on-one match. Sleek. Oh, the old drunk arc himself is here. Guy! Monica, he is also playing double duty tonight.
Yes. By my side I have Guy's girlfriend and Mario Cervantes.
So, what is the story of this match, Mario Cervantes?
I strongly believe it is because Guy has some unpaid debts to Slick. Slick is very angry, and now he wants to take revenge on him.
Yes, why is he not defending his title belts? Why is he pulling a double duty?
I don't have honest idea why is he pulling a double duty. Maybe because he really hates Slick's guts, and I hate him too because I never disagree with my boyfriend.
That is perfectly understandable, Mario Cervantes.
Well...
Slick is already tired of Guy. You know, the taste will make a very nice team. I just hope they are able to fight.
Whoa.
Slick tries to beat him, but Slick is very aggressive, whereas Guy is very fast.
Yo, honey, I can believe in you.
You know he can't hear you, right?
Don't tell me lies. I hate you.
Come.
Look what you did, Rob. You made an innocent little girl cry.
I was trying to be factual.
You don't need to tell the facts if they hurt.
Slick is coming.
Guys, you are a good figure. Who said my boyfriend can't fight? He is a good little boy.
Well, whatever you say, Mario Cervantes. Slick is not taking this very well.
Well, can he really? You can't really play him for not taking it well, do you?
Why are you so passive-aggressive today?
I don't know. I'm in a bad mood. And every time I'm in a bad mood, I feel bad. Because I just want to be happy, happy, happy with all of my friends.
Not my fault, little honey. Maybe Guy will figure out a way to destroy Slick. Guy is not using his amazing running starts enough in this match. Well, no, Guy is extremely fast. Whoa! That was intense. He almost got a victory there, but Slick was simply too powerful for him.
Whoa! Guy is amazing, Flipper.
He is. I love him. My beautiful boyfriend.
Oh, that must leave a mark. Slick! He almost got a victory over there, but Guy is not giving up.
Boo! Bring me your best, Slick. Ooh. Slick, do your best.
I don't think he can do his best here. This is a brutal environment. If Slick loses... If Guy loses, we all lose.
Who is that guy?
That is Pam Carrado, a famous indie star. He is making a guest appearance here tonight. He was supposed to be hosting the award ceremony for the greatest non-independent wrestler, making a pathetic attempt at relating during the coronavirus award of 2020, but he is apparently wanting to take part in this match.
Well, why could he have interfered in different matches?
Maybe he likes this. Maybe he will shake hands with Guy.
Yes, Guy is the most popular RWL wrestler. He is my little baby boy.
I think Maria is starting to get a little bit creepy in my face.
Oh no! That was absolutely brutal.
slick is going to take everything. Oh, we almost got submission, but Slick throws him.
We almost included a suplex of some kind, but Slick is not taking very well.
Slick could easily destroy Guy if he wanted to, but I have strong hope that Guy will eventually destroy Slick.
Will Slick tap? Whoa, that was an amazing counter.
Slick is... Guy is not giving up despite the bloody face that he has. Slick is too slow, but Guy is extremely fast. I don't know why he doesn't try to benefit from that more.
Maybe because Slick is absolute madman.
You should not rebel against him. He is a very powerful and very demanding person. A former crap hole member.
Who later betrayed Admin P and went to join the Taker Dance.
Guy is a winner. I strongly believe. What is this man's shit talking us?
Yes, we have to cut his home because that is too offensive for the little kids.
He looks like we are going to have to take him. We will go, RWL will go one-on-one against Notorious Strong Style Best.
I hate these guys. Guy has scared. Slick has lost. We have two matches remaining before the show is over. Let's find out what we have next in store.
It's hardcore one-on-one.
It's Intercontinental Champion Newt. I wonder if this is for the International Championship. That should be very exciting. Oh no, it's Linda Turkey. The psychotic. Somebody from Home Task Force Homeless. This is a homeless interview. Newt was earlier on the show commentating on Booby Beckler vs. Dave Rose title.
Whoa, this should be extremely interesting.
A battle between a hardcore character and a very oppressive person. Yes, Homer and Patrons have had a long time fight. This should be...
Lead Turkey is too busy flipping him off, but will he take the International Championship?
I have no idea. This should be a very balanced contest.
Oh! He beat me up like a sack of potatoes.
No, that is not a good sign. Newt has dynamite in his hand.
Somebody's going to get blown up.
And I just received info that Linda Serki has also farted two farts in one night. Oh, the humanity.
Stop it, Will. Linda Serki, after Ritkus D. Jefferson has been
too lazy to perform in RWL, so she is representing the homeless group. Yes, if she wins, this is going to be a big victory. The International Championship here is also known as the Dulcine Nuggets Nugget Weight Championship. This needs a new normal nugget special for normal people.
Oh my goodness, that was an amazing explosion.
Linda Serki the robot exploded fast considering it was a fucking explosion.
Will you take the victory? Oh no!
Newt is pretty still the Intercontinental Champion. Newt has taken the lead.
Well, I don't know. Well, what is going to be our main event for the evening?
I don't know, but I am suddenly... I have been getting some requests
I strongly believe that it is time to defend the RWL Championship. Who is the lucky one to challenge the current champion, Andorra El Gigante, Andre the Giant's Mexican equivalent?
What is happening? Is there going to be a championship match?
I don't know, honey. I have no idea, but it should be arriving sometime soon.
Forget everything, Rob. For our next match will be a 8-man to-the-death match for the RWL Championship.
Whoa, that sounds exciting. Who's going to be in it?
We will see, Rob. Whoa, Inferno, Yubi, Pokemon, and of course the Andre the Giant's non-Union Mexican equivalent Andorra El Gigante is here. Dark Bottom for the first match and Death River as well as Sleek. A lot of news on here. Well, but where are all the main faction leaders?
No idea. Sebas Kalesko is here too. And Yubi.
Yes, Yubi has a chance. Imagine that. Yes, this is a good kid. This means that everyone is fighting until everyone's. Rate has gone to zero. This means the only last man who has the most energy will be the victor.
I hope it's not Prototype. That man is absolutely evil.
Sebastaleko is out. The weak needs to get out first, as they say. Inferno, however, is extremely strong. He is training on Yubi Prototype attacks for them, but here comes Yubi. And Andorra El Gigante is still attacking Sebas, although he is supposed to be eliminated. Inferno and that for the fight, but here comes the third one. This is an exciting match. This will determine the world order.
But what about the all the characters here? There are no faction leaders present.
Well, I have no idea why there are no faction leaders. Oh boy, Andorra is really his worst here. And so is you, and so is Darkford, but especially Prototype is absolute monster.
Yes, but he does have his weaknesses too. When you would know, he is attacking Inferno.
Inferno is a powerhouse for all the Prototype is full power. Oh my goodness, that was first just a big man like Andorra El Gigante.
Andorra just tackled him on the ground like no man's business.
You can tell me. Inferno is getting assaulted. Dark Horton just put Yubi to trash can.
Where did Dark Horton even come from?
He is an alternate dimension Dark Horton who joined Hyphis and waged a war against all the other factions. An evil character, truly indeed. Now he's coming to the...
Whoa, that sounds interesting. Whoa, and Andorra El Gigante is back in the ring and now he's out of frame again.
Yes, Prototype is very powerful, but so is he. Yubi is gone. Now it's just Dark Horton, Andorra El Gigante, Inferno, and Prototype.
Was there supposed to be a Aegta already gone?
That's fast.
So it was Sebas Kalesko, Deathwaver, and who was the other two?
No idea. I actually don't remember. Were there only seven guys?
Oh, Andorra El Gigante is getting ready to kick some serious butt.
You can say that again.
Whoa, Andre,
yeah, that was dark. Prototype is still attacking Yubi, although... Well, thankfully, these people are wasting their finishers, but... thankfully, the intention of this match is to create as much damage as possible. Look at Inferno and Darkfold, and I wouldn't mind these two having an actual match.
Whoa. But RWL, Dark Fortum is now out. Only three of these men can win.
Yes, during the RWL 26-year long household war, RWL Gigante somehow will become my champion because... Renzi Backtrackings really wanted to find a big man to draw the money because they temporarily towed with Circus Hall A.
That's very unfortunate. Let's hope one of the RWL homebrew boys wins this championship.
I would not have minded you, Bibi. Shame that she had to be. Maybe one day she will get her chance.
Inferno, he should be... Prototype should be taking it like a man. And here he goes.
Prototype is dangerous. He is absolutely low. One hit and he is gone. But Andre is still having a lot of...
Whoa! Don't mess with Inferno. He can beat you up even though you are 8 feet tall.
From what I have heard, Andre El Gigante is actually just 7 feet tall. He just looks bigger because he's wearing high heels.
Well, I am not going to judge him on that. Prototype's gone. That means it's up to Inferno to defer the honor of the RWL title.
I'm sure he can do that, but not now.
What is Andre saying?
He's probably said something like, I have to go pee or something.
Whoa!
Here comes Andre El Gigante. A powerful man, yet he lacks some certain... He has certain perception issues.
I'm very sorry. Whoa!
From what I know, he had a short gimmick where he was managed by the Renzi Backtrackings as the true draw of RWL, but now Inferno is trying to take the honor of Andre El Gigante from his hands.
Whoa! Inferno is kicking his ass through and through.
What is Prototype planning? Maybe he might sabotage this match.
Whoa!
Inferno is reversing Andre's grasp.
Whoa! This is not good. What is Andre doing? Where is he going?
I have no idea. This is all part of his plan.
Whoa!
Andre missed, but now he didn't miss. Andre is gonna be thrown out of the ring for the umpteenth time.
No,
not yet.
Now
he's gone. Is Inferno going to be the next RWL champion? That would be exciting. He would make Clarence Mason and the entire crap all proud if he won the championship.
That would be absolutely amazing. Oh! Andre is directing back. He refuses to give up the title.
Don't worry. I'm sure he will find a way. That is not going to... If that doesn't finish Andre, I don't know what will. Inferno, what an absolute destructive powerhouse that man is. And to think he is almost too powerful, him to be kept alive.
You can say that again.
And he is, I strike back. Oh no, Andre. New RWL champion. That must hurt him to throw a big man like that. But Inferno is the new RWL champion. That is not good.
I think we fucked up a bit.
Well, see you all next week. Hopefully that time we have a real world champion.